Okay, great. We're going to work on two exercises from decision analysis practice problems, and they're exercise 3 and exercise 4. So let's start with the first one, exercise 3. So what we have here is a fashion designer. So she wants to produce a new line of clothes, and in the production of clothes, so different materials can be used, expensive, medium, or inexpensive. So expensive clothing, if the economy improves, her profit is going to be 80K. If the economy stays the same, her profit is going to be 40K. And if the economy gets worse, that's going to be 10K. So there are three market conditions here. That's where the uncertainty comes in, because we don't know what the economy is going to be. And the economist believes that there's a different probability for each one of them. For example, economy improves for 20% of the time and stays the same for 70% of the time and gets worse for 10% of the time. Okay, so first, using all those information, no any other additional information, we should be able to calculate EMV for each one of those materials, which options we take. Expensive, medium, or inexpensive. So we can calculate EMV based on the expected monetary value. We can choose the best option for this fashion designer. So let's start working on that first. Okay, so for the very first one, I'm going to consider expensive materials. And so the EMV can be calculated 80K multiplied by 20%.2, 40K multiplied by 0.7, 10K multiplied by 0.1. So I'm going to write it down here. Right, and that's going to give us 45K. I'm going to write it down here. It's 45K for expensive material. And for medium material, it's going to be 47K. And for the inexpensive material, it's going to be 29K. Well, so now the options are very clear. So based on the EMV, we know that she is better off if she use medium materials, because that's going to give us the highest EMV, right? EMV. Without any additional information, just use the information provided by the economist. The EMV is going to be 47K when she uses medium materials. Okay, next, there's a fortune teller, and she sees the future and knows exactly what economic condition will happen and how much are you willing to pay her for this perfect information. Well, if the fortune teller knows the economy, whether it improves or not, based on that piece of information, we can tell the fashion designer what option she should choose. For example, if the economy improves, clearly out of the expensive or medium inexpensive clothing, our fashion designer should choose the expensive one, because that's going to give her the highest profit. If the economy stays the same, she should choose the medium clothing. If the economy gets worse, she should also choose the medium clothing. So that means the highest payoff for economy improves is 80K. Economy stays the same as 60K. And if economy gets worse, that's 70K, right? We also have their respective probability, because there's a 20% economy is going to improve. So that means 80K multiplied by 20. And 70% of the time, the highest profit this fashion designer is going to make is going to be 60K, and 70K for 10% of the time. So based on those information, we can calculate EMV with perfect information, perfect info. And that's going to be 80K multiplied by 20 plus 60K multiplied by 7.7 plus 70K multiplied by 10% or 0.1. So that's going to give us EMV of 65K, right? So what we're going to do right now is, without the fortune teller's information, the fashion designer is able to have a profit of 57K. With that piece of information, she is able to make even more, 65K. So how much are you willing to pay? Are you willing to pay, say, $10,000 more? Well, I don't think so, because without the fortune teller's help, she was already able to make 57K. And the maximum amount of profit she's going to get with that additional information from the fortune teller is only, the difference between those two is only $8,000. So the fashion designer should not be willing to pay for anything more than $8,000. So I'm going to write it down. not more than $80,000, right? Okay. Hopefully this part is clear. And let's move on to question four. Okay. So what we have here is we have a decision tree and we want to use EMV rule to state the optimal strategy. Okay, you probably have seen this kind of trees in the slides in the videos. Okay, so what we want to do here is to solve the tree. We go from the right to the left. So I'm going to start with here, the very last end. There are different decision nodes and there are chance nodes. Okay, I'm going to just quickly write it down here. This is a decision node. So decision node, we're going to make a decision. We're going to decide which one we're going to choose, which action to take. So that usually involves choosing the branch that leads us to highest EMV. And a circle represents chance node. Chance node has probability associated to different branches. We want to calculate the expected EMV at a chance node. I'm going to show you what exactly I meant. So let's start from here. The first node I see is a chance node. 355% of the time, $100 payoff 45% of the time. So this is a chance node. We are going to calculate the EMV at this chance node. So let's do that. It's going to be 300 times 0.55 plus 100 times 0.45, right? If you do that, that's going to give us 210. Okay, 210. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write it down. Here is 210. The payoff is 210. I'm going to erase this one. Okay. And we move from the right to the left. So this is 210. This branch leads to EMV of 210. And the next branch leads to EMV of 180. And at the square node, the decision node, we have to decide which path we're going to take. Are we going to take 210 going through path H? I'm going to take a payoff 180 going path J. Certainly, we want to go with the 210. So take 210, right? Okay, we're going to move on to the next cluster of nodes. So we do the same thing here. So again, it's a circle node. We're going to calculate the EMV here. So you can do that. I've already done it. The EMV is 62.5. And same goes here. You can calculate the EMV as well. And that's 45, right? So a decision node, three branches, 62.5 or 50 or 45. So we certainly want to go with the 62.5. So that's going to be here, right? 60.5. Okay, so we are pretty much completed with this big branch. Let's take a look. So this is again a circle node. So we want to calculate the EMV here. So 25% of the time, that's going to give us 210 because we take the path of H. So this one at this here is 210. I'm going to write down here 210. And we're going to take this path of 62.5. So over here is 62.5, right? So we want to calculate the chance node EMV. Okay, that's going to be 210 multiplied by 25%. Plus 20 and 35 and 62.5, 40% of the time. Right? That should give you 84.5. So I'm going to write down here at this circle note, the EMV is 84.5, right? Okay, so I'm going to move on to the next lower branch here. So again, it's a chance node. We calculate the EMV, and this is actually 80 here. So for the second chance node, the EMV is 100. Well, comparing 80 branch versus 100, we're going to go with this branch, right? So I'm going to highlight it here. Okay, and I'm going to carry over their EMV 100 here. Okay, so now another circle note, we can calculate the EMV here. So negative 50, 20% of the time, 100, 80% of the time. So the EMV can be calculated, and that's 70. Okay, so we're almost down here. Last decision note, 84.5 or 70. We certainly want to prefer the higher one, so that's going to be 84.5. Right? What's the final decision then? The first decision we do is we choose A, which allows us to go through this route. Okay, and we are facing three choices, C, D, E. If C happens, we are going to choose H, right? We're going to choose H. We're going to get a payoff of 210. Okay, if D happens, we don't have to do anything. If E happens, we are going to choose K, and we're going to end up with 62.5, right? Okay, so if C happens, we choose H. If E happens, we choose K, right? And final expected monetary value for the entire tree, expected payoff. Is just 84.5. Right. Great. This also ends this video, and I hope you enjoy it. See you in the next one.